Good afternoon, everyone, and happy Fresh Friday. I hope you've had a great week so far. Even though it is warming up outside, we're gonna be warming it up in the kitchen with an easy French onion soup recipe today. It's so simple. I'm gonna be showing you how to caramelize onions, how to make this delicious soup, and honestly, it only takes a few ingredients and a little bit of patience, so I'm excited to get into that. First, let's talk a little bit about Half Pike Acres in Owingsville, Kentucky. We wrote a little bit about them an hour ago if you wanna check that out, but they're a really great family-run, regenerative farm, and they have over 150 animals on the farm that definitely help that regenerative process, help with soil building, and they're just so dang cute. So check out those pictures, check out the farm. They still have some CSAs available. They do a vegetable CSA, you can do an egg add-on, and then if you check out their online store, you can also find some meat bundles and some beautiful flower bouquets. So check them out, and let's get started on the French onion soup.
To get started on the French onion soup, we are going to thinly slice up some onions. So I'm going to cut both ends off, cut it halfway through, and then remove the skin and any weird outer skin layers. And then we are just going to carefully thinly slice through these. You need about 2 pounds, which for me was 3 yellow onions. And I cut the other 2 off camera, so just be aware of that. And you can use whatever onion variety that you'd like. I just find that the sugar content and the sweetness of these yellow onions really does help with the caramelization and the flavor. But I have caramelized other different varieties before and it will turn out perfectly fine, so just use what you have. I'm just going to add these to a bowl on the side here, and it's going to look like a lot of onions at the end of this. But just like spinach, you start with a lot and it's just going to shrink down and exude all of its liquid, so don't worry. In a Dutch oven, I added 3 tablespoons of butter to melt at medium heat. Once that fully melted, I added in about a tablespoon or 2 of some olive oil, the onions, and then half a teaspoon of sugar. And we're just gonna mix this to coat everything. And then you are just going to let this chill for about 45 minutes to an hour. So this is gonna cook on the stove, occasionally come over and stir it. It's going to take about 45 minutes for those to fully exude their water and to start even showing the slightest signs of browning. So just keep an eye on it. It will have a bit of stickiness on the bottom of the pan, but we'll take care of that in a little bit. But you are looking for a good golden color on these. Once your onions get to about this point and start looking like this and smelling so fragrant, we are going to take a little bit of red wine vinegar to get the bits on the bottom because those are full of flavor. So I just did probably about 2 tablespoons in here and just did that and lightly with my spatula scraped the bottom to make sure we got all of that. Once that was fully good and mixed up, we added in a bit of salt, a bit of pepper, and then some flour. Mixed this up, cooked this for a minute to get that raw flavor out. I used 2 different brands of beef stock, which is why there is a slightly different color variation between these two, but you can easily make your own beef stock. I know a lot of vendors or farms will sell beef bones for you to make your own, but I took a slightly easier route today just to save a bit of time. So once we have that added in, we're going to add in a bay leaf as well, and then bring this to a boil. Once it gets to a boil, we are just going to lower it to about medium-low heat so that it stays at a simmer, and this is going to cook for 30 minutes. Once that was finished, I taste tested for salt and pepper and then pulled it off to this side. On a baking sheet, I have 2 oven-safe bowls, and I'm just going to ladle in some of the soup and top it with some toasted crostini, or you can find, you know, just some bread or croutons that you have. We're then going to top it with some shredded Parmesan cheese and then put this in the oven on broil for about 2 to 3 minutes. Just make sure that you keep an eye on it. I feel like every time I look away when I'm broiling something, that's when I burn it. Don't these look so good? Oh my gosh, they smell amazing. So just be careful when you pull these out that the ramekins will be very warm. I topped them with a fresh sprig of thyme and they were ready to go. Once you dip your spoon in, it is covered in melty, ooey gooey cheese and it's just so good. I hope you all give this a try and be sure to check out Half Pike Acres in Owingsville, Kentucky. Like I said, they have an awesome CSA and there are still spots available, so check them out. Thanks so much and see you next week, guys.